And it's Ken Kraetzer for Sons of American Legion Radio, RallyPoint.com, back at State University of New York Maritime College. Have a chance to talk with the head coach, Maritime Football, and that is Vincent Digaetano. And, Coach, you got a playoff game to look forward to, New England Bowl. Exciting time for your program.
Yeah, I really, it is an exciting thing for our program. It's really just really the result of like the hard work that the players have put in all season. We're honored to be able to go ahead and represent our conference and be able to go out and play such a storied program like Springfield on a great field and a great day. And it's going to be an unbelievable atmosphere. And we're really looking forward to a tremendous experience.
Well, since we saw you last, you went down to Washington, D.C. and had a very strong game at Gallaudet. Tell us a little bit about that one.
It's a great day. Obviously, it's their senior day, so tremendous respect for what Coach Goldstein does with that program. And it was just really great for us to travel well, get down there, be able to get off campus, get a win, in the regular season, be able to go undefeated on the road during the regular season for us was huge, especially being in conference like that. Overcoming travel, overcoming traffic, overcoming weather, anything that you can kind of imagine and adapt in our schedule is always key, but it's nothing different than what we've been asking them all year. And then obviously to be able to go ahead and represent the college against a conference opponent that we have had a lot of success with, but we've also had a tremendous rivalry with. And it's just a great experience for everybody all about, and especially for our families that travel down there. We had about 60-70 families that traveled down, which was a great experience for them too, to be able to close out the regular season.
Very good. And this week, a number of conference accolades about your players, starting with your quarterback, Tommy Wright. What a career he's had at Maritime. Tell us about some of the conference recognition your team members have received.
Well, we're tremendously proud of Tom because Tom ended up winning not only first team all-conference, but he also won Offensive Player of the Year. Nothing but respect for other players that were up for it. There's really some great players, the running back from Castleton and the quarterback from Husson, amongst other players that are definitely were more than eligible for the award and could have represented it in either way. So we're just honored that Tom was able to be selected for that. And that's really a testament to him, and not only the way that statistics, but the way he plays the game and the fact that coaches in the conference we were able to vote for him for that. And then, along with Tom, we end up with Brandon Drumgold. He'd be able to make first team. And Nick Acevedo on the offensive line has been, a guy with so much experience to be able to really do what's been done over here over the last couple of years and pass down that tradition. And then second team on offense, we were able to Christian Castle and be able to work with Corwin and be able to also have Dean Lynch, who's not only been a tremendous player for us, but as a captain and a leader on there too. And you think about it on defense, we were able to get Peyton Campbell and Liam Bailey, and Liam's leading the league in tackles. And Peyton has the career record for sacks as the first team players. And then and having Mav and having Snuffer had a tremendous season too. Probably didn't have as many plays. That has the statistics of it too. But realistically, we know he's a tremendous guy. And not only that, but we're looking for the future of Liam and having Justin Snuffer back next year to really kind of pass on some of the things that they've done over the last couple of years too. And then we have a number of honorable mentioned guys. And I'll probably end up missing a guy or two, but you end up with, Carl, and you end up with Curtis, and I'm just using names right now, and Jack Johnson, all of them ended up just contributing in so many different ways, and it was great to have them recognized. Oh, and Khalil Lewin too. We have some great running backs, but it was great for Khalil to go ahead and stand out from the pack too. And then on specials, we had both the punter and the kicker as first team players too. So, and without,
gotta have those special team guys.
Absolutely too. So it was great to see, especially with Gags being a freshman, being able to make the first team all conference punter. That's tremendous for him. And then Ian, who really converted over from lacrosse and really was kind of a walk on for us to be first team kicker, was huge too. And then last but not least is really Coach Benoit, who again has done a phenomenal job in keeping the program. When Coach Holmes departed for West Point, he was really the only one in charge at a point in time, and he was only here for about a month. So he was recognized too for being the assistant coach of the year. And not only has the offense performed, but he's been a tremendous guy on and off the field too.
Very good. Now, you go up to Springfield, and you were explaining what a reputation Springfield has in producing coaches and in physical education and football. Tell us a little bit about it. I hear they also know how to run the option.
Yeah, so we've gotten familiar with it with a couple of opponents, too, but you know, it's kind of one of those places. It's kind of the place that it all starts when it comes to triple option, and it'll be a tremendous opportunity for us, and it'll also be a huge challenge for us too. It's a storied program. It's a great atmosphere, and it's really the first. It's actually the first ever time that this program, in the modern era at least, will have an opportunity to take on an opponent like this, like Springfield. So we're really looking forward to it. We know they're going to be a very well coached team, and there's no doubt about that. It shows on film. It shows in the statistics. It shows from the history of it too. They're going to be extremely well coached. They'll be athletic, and it'll be a huge challenge for us. And not only are we looking forward to just the game, but the entire bowl atmosphere and just really representing our conference well.
Very good. Now, in our weekly football safety segment, maybe a thought about preparing a team to play in cold weather. A lot of ice and snow. All of a sudden, remember those days it was warm in the early part of the season. Now we're into winter, it seems like. What does a coaching staff have to do to prepare a team to play in a cold weather site?
I think one of the biggest things, more than anything else, is probably not making a big deal of the weather, making too much of a big deal of it. I mean, there's the obvious that you have to bundle up, and there's the obvious that you have to warm the body and be smart with certain concepts, but you don't want to pull out at all any of the things that you normally do. You want to be able to make sure that you don't make as big of a deal of it as possible, because the bigger you deal you make of it, it's more of a reason for everybody else to kind of look. But you know, we've had some experience. Our Anna Maria game was 40-mile-an-hour winds, and we saw some of the things that we struggled with. And you know, the Hampton game, we dealt with a lot of weather and conditions, and even Gallaudet last week. So I think for us, more than anything else, it's learning from past experience, learning what some of our players are able to withstand, some of the things that we have to prep them for, whether it be on the sideline or whether it be in the pregame or the halftime, or make sure the attire is correct or whatever the case may be. But I really, there's no acclimatization really. You can't just stand out in the cold and say, I'm going to get used to it, especially for kids that are not used to it. More than anything else, I think it's mostly us being able to go ahead and you know, modify our game plan to whatever the conditions are, and then to take advantage of what we think we can. And then I think the other thing too is to really, more than anything else, go with past experience.
Very good. And what's the game time up in Springfield tomorrow?
That's a 1 p.m. start.
Very good. Well, Head Coach Vincent Digaetano of Maritime College, thank you. Wish you well up in your bowl game, the New England Bowl up in Springfield. And a special thank you for working with us all season long.
Thank you, Ken. And I also want to take an opportunity to thank not only you, thank the college for this opportunity we've had, but then also thank all of our fans and also our parents, too. Our parents have been tremendous throughout the year and welcoming me in a short period of time. Having 6 or 7 days to prepare for an entire season is not the norm, but being able to come in and really a testament to what our coaching staff was able to do and our players. But I really think it's important to recognize the parents that are behind that have supported us through the entire season.
Coach, it's been a pleasure. Best wishes from everybody at the American Legion and the 1.5 million veterans at rallypoint.com. Have a good game up in Springfield tomorrow.
Thank you, Ken.
Pleasure. This is Ken Kraetzer at the Maritime College in Throgs Neck, New York.